Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. I'm hoping you guys are all having a fantastic day. So, I already tried recording this video once, and I went through the whole entire thing, but then only to realize that the recording area that I was recording in was small at the beginning, and then I tried enlarging it, and I didn't know it would mess up. It just didn't work out. So, if I seem a little bit more tired this time around, it's, you know, because I'm repeating the same stuff for another video, so I do apologize if I do that, but if you'd like to get more of these updates about the weather, then consider subscribing to this channel. Helps the channel grow, helps me, it lets me know that you guys like what I do, so it's the best way. If you want to, you know, it may not seem like a lot, just one subscribe from one person, but every subscriber counts, so thank you for doing that. I was also thinking about doing a preliminary fall outlook soon. If you want to make one soon in the next coming days, leave it, let me know in the comments below. I was considering waiting a couple more days, but I'll see. Depends on the demand. So let's just jump into this. You remember a couple days ago I made a video about how the fall temperatures, how the fall temperatures are possibly going to make a comeback. And I say comeback because it was pretty chilly before this warm phase of air that we got. But, you know, that's what I said a couple days ago. We may see some September temps. I think that's what was in the video. You know, some September-like temperatures. And at this point, guys, the models have maintained that throughout their runs. And it seems like we will be looking at quite a few days where it could be feeling like September. So I want to update you guys on that. And just give you an overall kind of a long range in terms of maybe the precip as well. So if you quickly look at the 8 to 14 day outlook from July 6th through the 12th of 2019, obviously, we see that it has changed from a couple of days ago when I showed you. I'm pretty sure I did. If I didn't, well then it was basically still warm in orange colors across most of the country. A few spots of blue. Now the blue has expanded, and it's, you know, the colors are definitely have changed. Is it insane confidence? No, they're showing a 50% confidence of it being below average, and it's probably gonna drop or go down to. Or go up as much as 80 to 90% chance of it being below average, because some of these anomalies are going to be pretty great. And not like great, awesome, but they're going to be great in terms of magnitude. So let me show you these temperatures. Let's first look at the anomalies for so you could get a feel of what I'm talking about. And by the way, this is getting recorded, this video, if you're looking at these model data, these runs, I should rather say. It's 00Z Saturday because I'm recording as of, well, now it's Saturday. It's 12:02 a.m. So, yes, it's fairly late, and I will be uploading this in 10 hours. So, I'll just schedule to upload it, and it'll upload itself. But I will make everything due. And the reason is I don't think, time for a video tomorrow. And if I do, I'll try working on a fall outlook. So, it won't really be a time for a video about these temperatures. So right now, we could see some areas warm, you know, some areas very warm. I mean, this, if you see this anomaly during the summer, especially around July and August, where the average is around 85 to 90, and you see a 12 degree anomaly, you could be looking at almost triple digit heat. So you're much rather to see these blue colors during the peak of the summer heat. You just don't want this hotness unless you really work at the pool, or you have an interest in it really being hot. But otherwise, many people get tired by this heatness, this heat, I should say. I know I enjoy it. I love it for a period of time that is doable. But I also don't like when it's, you know, freaking 70 degrees or 60 degrees in the middle of July. That's a little bit too cold. But that's what we'll be looking at with this. I just want to give you a taste of what's to come. So you can see up until, I would say, July 6th, which is a Saturday, the cold air doesn't seem to make that much of an impact. You can see it starts making an impact across the northernmost part of the country. But for a big chunk of the country, it does stays confined to the north and up until Saturday. You can see warmth across here, warm to the south, and around average, maybe a bit chillier across the plains, still relatively warm. You can see it dives down this first wave, but doesn't do much beyond the South Dakota border and northwestern Minnesota. Look at that, it dives down, but kind of just stays there for quite a while, while this warm air is trying to push. So basically, I'm just going to draw this out. So if we look at, basically we have a high pressure right here, and it is spinning itself clockwise, and it's revolving all of this warm air from this Gulf of Mexico. I mean, there's plenty of it here. Whether it's in oranges or not, it's warm in nature, and it revolves it all around, and it's trying to push against this this cold air, which there's a high pressure down here, up here, spinning also clockwise, bringing this cold air down to the south. So they're kind of clashing, but eventually there's going to be a series of highs coming down from Canada, which will lead to way more strength compiled against just other than, you know, just one high pressure. So our 162, we keep going forward, and you can see that eventually the warm air gives in, and look at that, a whole chunk of the U.S. is covered in chillier conditions, chillier, I don't know, just dug back, chillier temperatures. Look at that, I mean, some locations pretty damn chilly. Look, I'm sorry about that, but pretty chilly, 16 to negative 20 to negative 12, and that is fairly chilly. Again, I would much rather to have this above me than that across the, you know, the central U.S. I mean, if you had, you see those colors right there? I don't know if you could see that. Those bright pink, that's like 20 degrees above average. If you lived in the south, your average is around 89. Say, I don't know where the average is, 89. Maybe northern Georgia. If you give it a 20 degree boost, you're looking at 109. So you definitely would rather to see some cooler temperatures like this, where if your average is say 85 across Missouri, let's just give it 90 is it, 85 is your average, and you see a 10 degree cool off, 75, that's comfortable. You don't have a problem with that, unless you find that cold. I mean, this doesn't seem to be so aggressive all the time. I think it will stay chilly for a good chunk of the coming long range, up until, I would say, mid-July, at least. But you could see it not at that strength. I mean, a little bit cooler, sometimes a little bit warmer other times, but generally still a cool pattern for the central U.S. The only areas I would like to point out that will seem to be saved from this cold air is anywhere. I would say the cold air will impact these areas the most. I don't know if you could see that blue line, but I think these areas will get the most impacted by this. Sorry about that. I did not mean to move that. I think that anywhere south and west and east of these areas should be fairly warm, if not well above average. And across these areas, it should be below average. And that's just kind of how the Climate Prediction Center forecasted it to be in their long-range seasonal outlook. And let me tell you, they were pretty spot on with that. I'll have to give that to them. I wasn't too convinced right at the beginning, though. I was definitely seeing some signs based on the analogs, not even analogs, just based on a past winter and spring, but also looking at the long-range models. But I wasn't convinced, but now I'm pretty sure that this summer will be chilly. Obviously, we're right now in a warm phase across much of the country. I mean, there are heat advisories, heat warnings, excessive heat watches across a good chunk of the plains. And those, you know, those areas will be seeing pretty chilly conditions relatively in a couple of weeks. So, it's not to go without that a cold summer or chilly summer will still have its fair share of hot temperatures, maybe just not as much as a warm summer. Obviously, I don't think I have to explain that, but sometimes people, when I say cold summer, you know, they literally think I mean like 60s and 70s each day, but it requires only a couple of these days, even like a week of straight of these anomalies, and it could put the whole summer at a chillier phase. And you can see some days a lot, not that bad. I mean, look at this. This is not that bad at all compared to average. If your average is 85, you would be probably looking at 80s right now, like 80 flat, maybe 79. So not bad. And then we see another wave, and look at that. That one's pretty chilly. Oh my, I'm running out of time right here. It's a 9:20. In terms of seconds, and I don't want to go over 10 minutes because then I have to start a new video. But I wanted to show you the actual 2 meter temperature shaded, and look at that. During the night, 50s, which if you're in a gardening, I mean, look at how cold that's gonna be. Holy cow, possibly not even getting out of the 60s here across this portion. So very, very chilly, and we'll just have to see some alarming, you know, some alarming, interesting things are going on. But again, look at the southeast. They're spared from this. So thank you guys so much for watching. Consider liking the video. Consider subscribing, and I'll catch you all guys in the next episode.